Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Nurse Pauline RN. I am doing this video to assist nursing students to be successful in their fundamentals of nursing exam. On my channel, I only tell you everything you should expect to see on your fundamentals of nursing exam. The title of my video today is Hygiene. In order to do hygiene for your patients, you should be a culture sensitive nurse. Provide privacy for your patients. Wash your hands before, during, and after care. We should consider the elderly. The elderly, their skin is very fragile, very dry, and we have to be gentle when we are turning them to give them their baths. Their skin, usually, if you grab them too hard, they will develop skin tears. Avoid friction of skin because their skin is fragile. Use gentle soap and water. Test the temperature of the water before you start giving them their bed bath. Use commercially prepared disposable pre-soaked wipes. Some of these wipes comes with moisturizers, vitamin E. Use barrier cream to bony prominences. Use a no rinse dry shampoo in their hair. Usually their hair is very oily. The no rinse shampoos you'll just lather and just towel dry. For contact lens, you'll store contact lenses using manufacturer's storage solution, or you can just store contact lenses in saline. You clean the eyes with cotton tips moistened with saline to remove encrusted dry solutions from the eyes. Wipe the eyes from the inner canthus to the outer canthus. When you're giving oral hygiene, wear gloves. Encourage patients to assist in their hygiene. Teach patients to floss and brush their teeth every day. Registered nurses assisting with bed baths enables her or him to do a complete and thorough head-to-toe assessment by inspection and palpitation. Inspection of skin involves sense of sight. Most important purpose of a bed bath is to cleanse, refresh, give comfort to clients. Preparation of bed linens is done with set of clean linens. When the doctor orders bed care, he means massage of the back. CBR means complete bed rest. Bed making refers to bed made with fresh linens. Avoid fanning of soiled linens to prevent contamination to the environment or even yourselves. Patients with specialized hygiene are diabetic patients, patients with artificial airways, unconscious patients, patients with chemotherapy. Patients with chemotherapy, you should encourage them to use a soft to toothbrush, they can use toothettes also. Inside their mouth is usually sore due to chemotherapy. Before you're braiding a patient's hair, make sure you have permission from them or some of their families. If a patient is of the Rastafarian religion, if they're unconscious, do not cut their hair without their family's permission. If patient is on isolation, wear gloves, mask, and gowns. Do not shave beards of patients. Shaving of beards in some cultures, that's a spiritual symbol. Even if your patient is unconscious and they have a beard, do not cut off that beard. I've heard sad news about that, which happened in the past to a patient. Priority care for hygiene are patients who is having loose stools or diarrhea. SITZ bath 20 to 30 minutes for women of childbirth, patients who have had hemorrhoidectomy, incision and drainage of abscesses. For diabetic patients, do not use lotion and creams between the toes. You can use toe pad cushions or you can use the toe socks. Keep between the toes dried. Teach patients to have a dental checkup every 6 months. Children admitted with lice, the doctor will give you a prescription how to take care of the hair. Usually they use that Quell shampoo, lotion, creams. I've seen that on an exam in the past, a test taking exam about that Quell. You should encourage families not to share combs of children who has lice, not to share hats, not to share brushes, not to share headwear. Wash clothes with hot water. Wash brushes with hot water. For perineal care for the female patients, the female patients will be in the recumbent position. You'll wash from front to back. Perineal care for the male is in the supine position. For uncircumcised male, you'll retract the skin when given care. Diabetic patients should be referred to a podiatrist. Do not cut their toenails. Patients with loose fitting dentures, assess their mouth for soreness or lesions. You can use a denture adhesion like Polydent or Fixodent. If patient NPO, this does not mean that they cannot have oral care. They can have oral care, but do not swallow the water. For women after childbirth, they can wash their breasts with just plain warm water. You can teach them to wear supportive bra. They should not use soap that will dry the breasts. Patients on blood thinners, Plavix, aspirin, and heparin. Avoid using razors for shaving these patients. Patients with hearing aids should be placed in the bedsides when not in use with a cup or container with a lid. Put the patient's name on this container, please. Patients with denture, when denture is not in use, place denture in a denture cup with a cover at the bedside. put patient's name on your denture cup. Sometimes patients leave hearing aids and dentures on the trays of which they are eating, and everything goes out in the trays. When cleaning patient's ear, observe the ear first for foreign bodies. You retract the ear downwards to remove any wax from the ears. You will remove artificial eyes with gloves. Depress the lower lid. Remove with index finger and thumb. Place artificial eyes in container with lid with the patient's name. Place artificial eye in saline. Please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and please share my video and comment. Hope you have a great day. Thank you.